Greetings. Ah, the Surah of Sour Grapes. You've probably heard it before without even knowing it, after you've argued a Mohammedan to a standstill. And that is no small feat if you can do so without angering or offending them. But you have certainly frustrated them when they get to this point, after you've argued a Mohammedan to a standstill. And he won't listen and comprehend what you say. He'll toss out this recitation of recalcitrant resistance. To you your religion, and to me mine. That comes from the Surah of Sour Grapes, or Surah 109. Surah 109, Ayat 1. Say, O ye that reject faith, say, O disbelievers. Ayat 2. I worship not that which ye worship. I do not worship what ye worship. Ayat 3. Nor will you worship that which I worship. Nor are you worshippers of what I worship. 4. And I will not worship that which you have been wont to worship. Nor will I be a worshipper of what you worship. 5. Nor will you worship that which I worship. Nor will you be worshippers of what I worship. 6. To you be your way and to me mine. For you is your religion and for me is my religion. And there you have the short and sweet of the sour grapes. That didn't take long. Let's go through it in more detail and look at all the logical flaws in it. Say, O ye that reject faith! Notice the author incorrectly creates a false choice. You either accept Mohammed's religion, Mohammedism, or you are rejecting faith. Let's help edit Mohammed's Quran to make it clear. Say, O ye that reject Mohammed's religion! Say, O disbelievers in Mohammedism! That is much clearer, don't you think? And it is actually factually correct now. People who reject Mohammedism do not reject faith, only faith in Mohammed. I worship not that which you worship. Mohammed hit that nail square on the head. Mohammed did not worship the God of Abraham. Mohammed did not worship the real maker of heaven and earth. Mohammed did not worship the God of the Jews who sent Moses with the Torah. So this is one truth in the Quran. Mohammed does not worship the God of Abraham that we worship. I can never, ever again say there is not one word of truth in Mohammed's Quran. Oh well. Always remember, a liar will use truth to salt his poisonous lies. He is not limited to only telling lies. And Mohammed used snippets of truth over and over to sell his lies. Nor will you worship that which I worship. Damn, Mohammed hit two in a row. I will never worship the pagan demon Allah that Mohammed represented. And that is, for a fact, what Mohammed represented. A demon named Lucifer, Satan. He did not speak for Yahweh, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the God of Israel. And I will not worship that which you have been wont to worship. He summed up the past, I do not. Now he's exercising what little prophetic unction he has. He declares he will not worship what we worship. And perhaps logically you think it is in his control to make this declaration with some certainty. But on the last day, even Mohammed will bow his knee to the Lord Jesus Christ. So even this attempt at prophecy by Mohammed is doomed to failure. Nor will you worship that which I worship. Again, his sour grapes rationalization, to commiserate his utter failure to convince a Christian to abandon God and follow him. This is just one more proof that the Quran is Mohammed's thinking and his logic to control Mohammedans. Or do you really think this is how the Lord of the Worlds frames a parting shot in an argument he has lost. It's called getting the last word in. To you be your way and to me mine. And that really is the final damning admission that the Mohammedan has no regard for truth. He has his Allah, Muhammad, and his Allah's word, Muhammad's Quran. And he is unwilling to continue the pursuit of truth because he assumes what he has is the truth. And he has exhausted all the claims and stories and tales and arguments he has. To you your religion and to me mine. And now you know about the Sura of Sour Grapes. So what can you do with that answer? Not much, because that is what Muhammad intended when he wrote it. It is not intended to be an open door for reconciliation. It is a closing of the mind, a shutting of the door, a blinding of the sycophant. But even though Muhammad framed it to close their mind, you can still present the truth in love. Remember, our mission is to present the truth. God gives the increase. God opens their heart. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.